Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I just feel like singing. Praise the Lord. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me. Every time I turn around,
myself, but I'm glad when you're here to help me. Pray for Lord Jesus.
Praise the Lord. So I'm glad for every one of you wonderful people of God. I see smile on their face and I see the glory of God on the face of God's people. And our visiting friends who are here with us today, God bless you. God bless you, my dear sister, Jenny's mother, who sung so beautifully for us today. If I only go the last mile of the way. Hallelujah. It will close that day, close of the day, and I will see the Lord in His beauty. Only if I go to the last mile of the way. Because the race is not for the swift and the battle is not for the strong, but those who endure to the end. And we have to be among those who endure to the end. Because Jesus says only those who endure to the end. So if we have been going for years and years and years, and at the very end, we decide to cut back. The Lord says, any man who put his hand to the plow and draw back, my soul has no pleasure in him. Praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. And our sister, those who are singing, I can't give up now. Come too far. Come too far. Too far. Too many roads and too many troubles. Too many pains and too many tears. And too many sorrows. So many crying and sighing and heartaches and pain. And hills that we have already climbed. And now we have to join the songwriter says, I just can't give up now. Come too far. Oh, praise the name of the Lord Jesus. You know, God loves brethren. The love of God is so amazing. Praise the Lord. I just want to thank the Lord for His mercy and His grace towards me. And you know, I have to sing that song because it's been bubbling. You know, so it's bubbling in my heart all the time. And I'm just walking around and this song is just bubbling in my heart. Every time I turn around, God is blessing me, you know. And there's just something there that you feel that God is doing something for you. And you feel something. And you've been singing, I feel like fire. And shut up in my bones. And lock up in the inside. It's something like compression. You know, there's a joy that as children of God that we should feel. And that's the only way we know that we are connected, because there has to be something on the inside. It's not about the outside. It's not about the feel good. It's not about the feel good and the pleasures of this world. It's about something on the inside. There has to be something on the inside. Praise the Lord. And you know, I just feel like God is blessing me. You know, we are called children of faith. And the Sunday school was telling us about faith. As I heard Sister Scott was teaching us about faith. And you know, how important is faith? Because without faith, it is impossible. We can't please Him. So it tells me that the more faith we have, is the better we please God. Praise the Lord Jesus. And many of the past have demonstrated their faith through their action, through their work. And Abraham is a father of faith. He is a father of faith. And we become part of the family of Abraham through faith. So we are engrafted through faith. You know, God said something to Abraham and He called him out of the land of the earth of the Chaldees. He said, go, Abraham, come out from among them to the land that I will show you. come out from that father's house. It's the same thing he said to us.
Yes, amen.
He said the same thing to us. Come out. Come out of the world. Come out. Be thou separated. And then because, which is faith, Abraham obeyed God. Because Abraham obeyed God, God made him a promise. God said, in blessing, I will bless thee. And in multiplying, I will multiply thee, that thy seed shall be like the sand of the seashore, and as the stars in the sky. Who can count the sand on the seashore? And who can count the stars in the sky? No man. But I can imagine when God said that to Abraham. Abraham was saying, me, Lord? Little me? Hallelujah. Little me, Lord, is going to have a seed like the sand of the seashore and as the stars in the sky. You know, Abraham wondered. But you know what happened? We serve a great God. We serve a great, big, wonderful God. And sometimes we wonder why God thinks of us and why God considers us. It's because he sees something in us. He has seen something in us. And that's why we have that promise that God will bless us with the same blessing that he blessed Abraham with. The same blessing. He said, cursed is them that curse you. And blessed is them that bless you. But we don't wonder how blessed and how wonderfully blessed we are. Do we really realize? Do we really, really realize how wonderfully blessed we are? Do we realize that? When you have God on your side, hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
The Bible says, if God is for us, so we should be moving around and walking around with a blessing. We should be blessed all around. You know, the scripture that I had, we had read earlier on, it says, Hebrews 1 verse 1, it says here, God, who at sundry times and in divers manner spake in time past unto our father by the prophet. So God, you know, I was once an accountant, and the word sundry is a word we use a lot in accounting. Sundry just means various. So if you have a pile of bills and you don't know where to place them, you place them into a sundry account. And so whatever is missing and you can't find it, you look in the sundry account. It means various. So God in various times and in diverse manner. So in various different times and in different manner, spake in time past unto the Father and unto the prophets and by the prophets. So God always speaks to his people. He has always a way to communicate with his people. And in sundry times he had different ways of speaking to man who is made in his image. He spoke to Father Abraham, he spoke to Moses, he spoke to Elijah, he spoke to Elisha, he spoke to Isaiah, he spoke to Jeremiah, he spoke to many various prophets. But he speaks unto his people. It's not everybody that God speaks to. God speaks to his people. When we see sometimes the world is going different ways and not hearing from God, because God is not speaking to them. God speaks to his people. But in time past, he spoke in sundry times, in diverse manner. He spake unto the fathers and prophets. But going on, he says, hath in last days, that is like today, spake unto us by his Son, whom he had appointed heirs unto all things, by whom also he made all things. So in time past he used the prophets, but in these days he speak to us by his Son. He speak to us by Jesus. Jesus, who was there from the beginning. God came and made himself flesh so he could communicate with us. You know, when someone talking to you, they're communicating. You know, I mentioned about malice in Sunday school, that if you're malice with somebody, it's because you're not agreeing with whatever they say or the attitude. So you cut them off. Malice. And it's a bad thing when God cut off anyone. Praise the Lord. We have to be connected. We have to be hearing from God. And if we say that we are in God and God in us, and we're not hearing from God, something wrong. Something seriously wrong. And when I come into the house of God, I come to hear from God. I come to hear what thus saith the Lord. You know, Wednesday night we was here in prayer meeting, and I always listen for the voice of God. And I don't know who's motivating, but there was a scripture from Matthew chapter 13. And it was very interesting that there was a parable there about sowing the seeds and how some of the seeds went on stony ground, some went among thorns, and some went on good ground. Good ground. But what I think came over to me is that when his disciples approached him, his disciples approached him, I think in verse 10. His disciples, Matthew 30, verse 10. His disciples came and said unto him, why speakest thou in parables? Why speakest thou in parables? You know, we know says a parable like, isn't it? Earthly story with a heavenly meaning. And Jesus answered them, and he answered and said unto them, because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. Because God needs to talk to his people before he talks to nobody else. God needs to communicate with his people. Says, if my people who are called by my name humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways and seek my face, I will hear from heaven. and forgive their sins and heal their lands. Praise the Lord. I'm talking about hearing from God. I'm talking about hearing from God. You know, we know the story of Saul. Saul was appointed king over Israel. First king over Israel. And he disobeyed God. In that God told him to destroy the Amalekites. The same bunch that came out of that lay with them. I said lay with when they come out of Egypt. Amalekite have confronted them. And as well, God said to Abraham, I will bless them that bless you and curse them that curse you. And they strove against the children of Israel. And God did not forget. God did not forget. And Saul displeased God because he did not follow the commandment that God told him to do. Slay all of them, everyone. So Saul said he repented. And afterwards, God had made a covenant with the Gideonites. And Saul went and killed them. Then vexed God again. Saul was going backwards instead of forward. He starts slipping. You know when you start slipping? Sometimes when you start slipping, you can't help yourself because you're slipping. So Saul starts to slip. And you know when we disobey God continually, God get angry with us. Get angry. You know God can get angry. You know God can get angry. He's a loving God. Absolutely loving God. His love is beyond measure. But God can get angry. And he got angry with Saul. And he withdrew himself from Saul. And Saul, there was a battle against the Philistines. And the Bible tells me that when the battle gets hot, Saul began to get frightened and scared. And he went to find a soothsayer, a witch. You see? He went to find a witch of Endor. And he went to the witch, and the Bible says he went to the witch by night and then disguised himself. Because what he did when he was king, he kicked out all the witches and all the thing out of Israel. So they want the woman to recognize him, so he disguised himself, come by night. But she knew it was Saul. And Saul wanted the witch to bring up Samuel from the dead to talk to him. If God stopped talking to us, nobody else will. Praise the Lord. If God finished with us, nobody else can help us. That's why it's so important that we stay close to God, brethren. So, so important. You didn't know the time when God left him. And we can tell story of people like Samson, who's lost the presence of God. But fortunately for him, he repented. Praise the Lord Jesus. When we're talking about hearing from God. Yes. The Bible says Saul had a javelin in his hand, but his spirit was cross. Brethren, when you have a little peace in your heart, you have a lot.
Yes.
Money can't buy peace.
Yes.
Peace comes from God.
Yes. Thank you, Lord.
You could be a millionaire, a billionaire, a trillionaire. Money can't buy peace. Peace comes from God. So even though he was the king at the time, He had no peace. And his spirit was cross. And David played the music and calmed down his spirit. Brethren, we have to have something inside of us to keep us.
Yes.
When the road gets rough, and when the going gets tough, if we don't have something on the inside, we're not going to be able to stand up. Praise the Lord. We're not going to be able to stand up. So, it just pleased God because of disobedience. Praise the Lord. But I look at these days now that we're into, and God is speaking to us through the Holy Spirit. It's a different time now. The time we're living in now, we can enter into the Holy of Holies. But we have to be clean.
Yes.
Now, because when Jesus died on the cross, the veil was rent in two, where the priest, the high priest, used to go. And, you know, no one else could go. And now the veil is rent in two, and we have access to the Holy of Holies. But we have to be clean to enter. We have to be clean to go there. Praise the Lord Jesus. So he opened up the veil. And now we can approach God Almighty. It's good. We can approach God Almighty. We can go down and call upon him. We can say, Lord, you see. And he healed. We can say, Lord, I am in need. We can say, Lord, I'm in trouble. And he healed. And he sent the answer. Wonderful. Wonderful. He is. You know, when he died and he resurrected from the dead, and he was about to ascend in heaven, he said, all power. All power.
All
power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Brethren, you see the connection we have?
Yes, hallelujah.
You see the connection we have?
Yes.
We are connected to an all-powerful God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. One that can move any mountain. What privilege. You know, going on in the scripture, the Bible says, which one of the angels up there did he call son? Angels are ministered in spirit.
Yes, they are.
The very last verse of this psalm, Hebrews chapter 1, it says, which, verse 30, says, to which of these angels said he at any time, thou art my son, sit at my right hand until I make thy enemies footstool. The angels are ministering spirits. Sent forth to minister unto them who shall be heirs of salvation. So angels, a minister is a servant. So the angels are there to serve us who are here unto salvation. So we are set apart people. We are a peculiar people. We are a holy people, a holy nation. And that's why when we read revelation. The Bible tells us that he who have an ear, let it hear. That's a word, you know. He who have an ear, let it hear what the angels said to the churches. Well, that tells me that the angels are not talking to the world. The angels are talking to the church, who is you and I. This building is not the church. We don't come for that. We don't come to worship a building. We come to worship a God who is alive, who liveth, who ever was, ever is, and ever shall be. Praise the Lord Jesus. So we want to hear the word of God. We want to receive the word of God. We want to follow the word of God. We want to live in the word of God. We want to walk in the word of God. We want to use the word of God. Praise the Lord. The woman at the well of Samaria, God wanted to give her something. So the Bible said, he knew she was coming. So Jesus sent his disciples to go buy meat because they wanted to have a one-to-one. Sometimes God wants to have a one-to-one, yes. But we have too much crowd around us. So God not talk to us. God not talk to us because we have too much crowd. You know, so things are mind are corrupt and things. God wants us to have a clear mind so we can listen and digest his word. So the woman came to the well, and Jesus sat upon the well, and the woman said, give me to drink. And she said, how come you being a Jew asking me, a Samaritan, to give drink? Because the Jews don't have no dealing with a Samaritan. But you know what? A different time now. Praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes. He said, if you knew who you speak, you know who's speaking to you. If you realize who is speaking to you, you will ask him to give you drink. And the water that I give you shall be a well of water springing up. Boy, I think the woman wanted some of that water. But I can't imagine that people thirsty and water is there and they don't want to drink. And go and beg for the water. The water is bubbling up and people were thirsty. It's like when people are in sin and they can't see Jesus, they're dying their thirst. Praise the Lord Jesus. And when the woman realized, because Jesus told her, Jesus asked him, bring your husband. She said, I don't have any husband. But Jesus said, yes, you have so many, and the one you have there right now is not yours. So immediately she started to wake up and get connected. That somebody knows something about him. So she said, oh my Lord. Sometimes we can water pot, you know. And the water pot not help us at all, you know. We want the real water. Praise the Lord Jesus. The water pot not help us, man. The water we carry not help us. Because the water we carry will keep us ready. And then the next day we have to go up for some more water. You have to keep going back. But the water that Jesus gave, we have to go back for it. Once you get it, you get it. Praise the Lord. So she was so excited. She said, I don't know how far she had to walk to come to the well. But when she realized who she was talking to, the the water that she walked so far to get became not important, became insignificant, because she saw something that she wanted all the time, but she didn't know where to get it. But she realized that what Jesus was going to give is something that she had hunger for. She had hunger for the peace. She had hunger for the joy. And they were all coming over when she speak to Jesus that this is something I want. I am here with our five husbands, but none of them is giving me no joy. But the man at the well. And the songwriter said, Jesus gave the water that was not in the well. Hallelujah. She went away singing. And she came back praying. Hallelujah. For she found the water that's not in the well. Oh, praise the Lord Jesus. And she had an ear. And she heard. And she heard. And she received. And she said, yes. Come see a man. Oh, hallelujah. Who told me all that I did? Is not this the Christ? I say when you meet and connect with Christ, you must be a change in you. You can't be the same. No one tells me that they have come in contact and encounter with Jesus and stays the same. Praise the Lord Jesus. So she was a changed woman. Hallelujah. And she began to evangelize same time. Oh, praise the Lord Jesus. Because she was ready. She was open for the water. Praise the Lord Jesus. He who has an ear, let him hear what the angels. Now, the angels are ministering unto us. And as we go along our way, the angels are ministering unto us. The angels are there and whisper the word of God to us. And we have to receive it because God is speaking to us. We serve a God who speaks to his people. We serve a God who is live and direct and live connection. And you know, sometimes when I see what God can do, I said, boy, I wish I had a little more strength. I wish I had a little more power. I wish I had a louder voice. I wish I could jump higher. I wish I could glorify God, because he is good and he never fails and he always brings me out. Hallelujah. David said, I was young and now I'm old. But I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. My God, what a God we serve. Thank you, what a God we serve. I just want to worship him right now. I just want to worship him right now. He never fails. He never leaves us alone. He's always there by our side. When trouble comes, he's there. Hallelujah. You know, I always said that the wicked one has a way to do things. Because a lot of people right now in prison because the wicked one whispers something in their ears and tell them that it is right when it's wrong. And the wicked one is one way to get you to do what you want to do. And he'll finish with you. And he's going to left you. You know, that's the problem with sometimes. You see people who do things and afterwards they start crying. They start crying because they realize that person, the spirit, I was talking this morning about the many spirits and Satan have company and all the thing. When the spirit come and tell them, say, yes, man, it's all right, kill them, man, they him deserve for dead, him too bad, and all those things. And when the man go and follow the spirit and go kill the man, then the spirit gone. The job done. Him done what he need to do, not to do anything more, the job done. But praise the name of the Lord, but our God. He's always with us, in every condition, in every situation. It doesn't matter what we are, where we are, how we are. As long as we are connected to him, he's connected to us, and he will bring us out. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Praise the Lord Jesus. So God in certain times, speak to the prophets, by the prophets, to our fathers. But now he speaks to us, to Jesus. And the word of God came from Jesus. It came to the disciples who became apostles. And then from the apostles, it came down to us. It's the same God, it's the same word transporting to us. So God is speaking to us in these latter days through His Son, through Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord Jesus. And we give Him glory. And we give Him praise. Hallelujah. Please stand with me. I'm going to sing, "My heart is on the altar now, waiting for the fire." Praise the Lord Jesus. My heart is on the altar. I'm waiting for the fire. Please stand with me. Waiting. It should be on the projector now. Praise the Lord. My heart is on the altar. I'm waiting for the fire.
Hallelujah.